Welcome to my fourth train tutorial. This time around it's going to be a bit shorter, but still interesting. I'm going to tell you a bit about different rail widths and track counts for your main line. So why should you even bother about having a conform rail width? Good question, simple answer. A good rail network is easy expandable and modifiable, which means that you just want to have a couple blueprints with you that can be mixed together to build everything. If you use different rail widths everywhere, then it's going to be a bit complicated and not that easy anymore. So it's just the easiest thing to plan ahead, as this is going to save you multiple headaches and most importantly, time. First off, I measure the rail width by the number of rails that fit side by side between both rails. So in a one rail wide track, one rail would fit between both rails. The smallest you could go would be 0 wide, with both rails directly touching each other, but this isn't recommended, just as one wide rails, as this will make it impossible to make a cross between both rails. Also, intersections would have very few room for good signaling. This is why you shouldn't use such narrow rail lines. Nice rail systems really start at 2 wide rails. This width is my personal favorite for smaller rail lines, as it allows for rail changes and fairly efficient intersections while still being fairly compact. But as I pointed out in my last train tutorial, you could achieve higher efficiency with wider rails. Two wide rail lines also allow for stuff being placed in the middle of them, such as roboports and power lines. Three wide rail lines really hit the sweet spot in my eyes, as they offer perfectly efficient intersections while still being as compact as possible. They also hold the advantage that I love from the two wide rail spacing, which is the ability to place stuff like roboports between the rails. With the four wide rail system, you could also get some fairly nice solar panel setups built into the rails, which would generate a bit of extra power for you. After tinkering around for a few minutes, I came up with this perfectly tileable setup. It's not perfect, as the ratio between solar panels and accumulators is 1:1, while you should generally have more like a 0.84 accumulators per one solar panel. But this adds just more energy storage, which never hurts. All this energy could be used for the integrated roboports and some optional defenses to defend our rail system against biters. Adding some laser turrets into the setup also brings the ratio to 0.9 accumulators per solar panel, which is a bit closer to what is generally agreed upon being a perfect ratio. You obviously could go even wider, but this wouldn't make much sense in my eyes, as you hardly gain any efficiency while needing a lot of space for your train tracks. So wider rail widths than 4 rails are not really recommended by me. You could, however, fit even more power production into wider rails, so you could play a bit around with different setups if that is something which is important to you. To this point, I just covered rail lines with a total of 2 rails, one for each direction. You could also build more rails into each direction to boost train throughput. In theory, this should work great. More rails are always better, right? Well, not in every scenario. Going to 2 rails for each direction might give you a respectable boost, but the higher you go, the smaller the return will get. The biggest problem in your train network are your intersections, and the huge and complicated intersections you would need for these big rail systems aren't much more efficient. So, to summarize, going higher than 1 rail for each direction might give you a small boost depending on your setup, but you will probably be better off to just optimize your train network instead of throwing just more rails onto it. I will, however, probably make another tutorial about this topic in the future, so make sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss it. That was already everything for today's tutorial. Next time I'm going to show you how to use the wonders of the circuit network to take control over your train system. Until then, have a great day, tell me what I could make better in the comments and rate this video. See you all next time.